Hey guys, Bud here with Dependable Lawn Care, and today I am going to be adding an hour meter onto my FW15. So I picked this up off of Amazon. It was one of the cheaper marine hour meters. It had really good reviews on it, and they're fairly inexpensive. This was less than $10. And I got the marine type simply because it's waterproof and I won't have to worry about if it gets wet. So it comes with the hour meter, wire, and two little screws, which is actually going to work out perfect for me because I think what I'm going to do, my spark plug wire is right here, and this plastic shroud on top of the engine, there's a lot of space behind it right here, so I think I'm actually going to screw it onto the plastic right there. But the way this works, so on the back of this thing, you see that that groove along the bottom? Okay, well, your wire just pushes down in there on one end. So you take one end of the wire and push it down in there, and then the other... And then the other end of the wire will wrap around your spark plug wire 5 times. And then you zip tie it, or you can use electrical tape. I've got a couple zip ties, so I'm just going to zip tie it in place. But it would actually work perfect because my spark plug wire is right here. I'd still be able to take the boot off of the spark plug to access that for maintenance without having to mess with this. So I'm going to wrap it around this wire 5 times, get everything set up, screw it in place, and then I'll show it to you when it's done. All right, guys. I'll show you up close here. I've got my wire wrapped around 5 times, nice tight coil, and then I zip tied this end, which I'm just gonna cut off outside of the zip tie. I've got to trim my zip ties off as well, and then the other end of the wire, I just have it ran wild right here, so that I can put it through my meter, and then cut it off where I need to before I screw the meter onto the shroud. So that's all in place, and all I've got to do now is finish everything up. Okay, it's all in place. Get up here close and show you. So you can see the wire running out right there. I've got my coil of 5. I'll probably put a piece of electrical tape around that just to kind of clean it all up. Of course, the electrical tape will probably get hot and fall off, but I'd just kind of like to have it covered up. But regardless, I screwed the hour meter right onto the plastic, which worked out good. It's in a good location. It's out of the way, but it's right on the front of the mower where I can get to it, keep track of the hours. So the only thing that's left to do really is start up the mower and let it run for a few minutes and make sure that it's keeping track of the hours like it's supposed to. Okay, I ran it long enough to roll over 0.2 hours, which was 12 minutes of runtime. While it's running, the little hour meter on the left flashes intermittently to let you know that it's keeping time. And going by the amount of time that it ran, it's accurate. So one of the reasons why I chose this specific one, other than just the reviews and the good price point, was also because it had color options. You could get it in, I believe it was black, yellow, and red, and I wanted red to kind of go with the mower. I just thought that would be a good match. But anyway, there it is, guys. So it's on there. It's ready to go, and now I can keep track of my hours. It's good to do for maintenance. It's also good to do for, trading in or selling the unit down the road, in 4 or 5 years or whatever, whenever I decide it's time to trade it in or sell it, or even if I don't, at least this way I can keep track of how many hours are on it. So, anyway, as always, guys, thanks for watching. Get out there and make some money, and we'll catch you on the next one.